Hello and welcome to back to the Columbus Zoo. This is going to be video number two that I've done here. The first one I did was from the heart of Africa. We're going to go to the other side of the Columbus Zoo, across the road, actually through the tunnel, to the old side where the aquarium is, and other things such as Congo, even the dinosaur ride and that kind of thing today. So enjoy the vlog. Well, it looks like they got that restaurant, those restaurants finished. That's going to be a new exhibit over here coming next year, Adventure Cove, it's called. In the distance you see Zumbezi Bay Water Park. Doesn't look too active today. The school is in back in session here. So it's probably going to be slow today. Stroller City. But looks like they're getting ready for Halloween, Fall Fest here. Of course the zoo does a fantastic look at this. Look at that. Jack Hanna. Yeah, Jack Hanna just had his 40th year celebration last week. So these pumpkins are probably in commemoration, for Jack Hanna. 40 years as director and director emeritus now at the Columbus Zoo. Celebration Lake right over here to the right. Wonderful looking. Oh, I got that hokey music still. I think they need some consult on music here in this park. All right, so this is Riverside Drive right here. We're in the northwest corner of Columbus, a little town called Powell, Ohio, and we're near Dublin too. They kind of butt up against each other. This is Riverside Drive, very busy. Two-lane, I believe it's two-lane. Sometimes it goes four-lane, but then you walk underneath here to the other side. Meet you on the other side. There we go. A little disagreement here. Sorry about the focus issue in the beginning part of this blog. I forgot to put it on autofocus. How you guys doing? This one's sleeping. All right, let's go on and see the rest. Here we have the alligators. I'm a little surprised they're out because it is a little cool. We're not gonna get probably up to, 72 today. Looks like there's one down in the water right over here too. Maybe the water is warmer than the air temperature right now. One of my favorite places is the aquarium. Not only do we have a fantastic zoo here in Columbus, but we have a nice aquarium as well. So let's go ahead and have a walk through here. This is kind of a new area I've not seen. Little play area. Kids can climb up on the whales and the turtles. And, oh, look at the surfboard over there. You can pretend to. Oh, look, I found Dory. This is the big aquarium. People actually even dive in this. It's the entrance over here. Like a big submarine. Nice. Sean would say nice theme in here. And then they have little tiny aquariums over here. Here's another dory. Little sound effects going on here. This is a touch pool that they have. It's not going to be open. I don't think they're going to have that open until, well, next summer. But then you come in here and you have a viewing area for the very, very large tank. conservation is a real big deal here at Columbus Zoo. Jack Hanna especially is really into the conservation. All right, now we're going to enter Manatee Coast. Probably one of the most well-known manatee rescue operations in the world. Here's another look. Go outside and then come back in. Here's another look to that play area in the 4D theater over there. So let's go ahead and take a look at Manatee Coast. So you walk in here, I think this is the mangroves right here in Florida. I actually did some paddling around with my brother Eric and Todd in the mangroves. And this is a pretty good representation of what that root system looks like. And in the channels, you see manatee all the time. So this is the manatee habitat.
Wow,
that's just the baby right there. They call them sea cows. Look at this guy, he's smiling at you. You think they breathe underwater, but they do not. They are mammals. Looks like this one's kind of coming up for a little breath. Put their little snoots in the air. I don't know if you can see that. And they take a breath and go back down. That is a big one right there. Looks like Mama's gonna come up for a breath. Why don't you just put your snout up there and takes a breath and goes on back there. Let's go see the rest. Manatee Coast. We are in the penguin area, Humboldt penguins, to be more specific. We've got some swimming around here. Looks like they're gonna jump in. Maybe. They seem to be following me around. Very, very slow here today, which is one of the reasons why I came when I did. But that was the most active I've ever seen those penguins. They were lovely. Oh, there's a carousel here. Probably not gonna be open today. But it's a lovely carousel. It's all enclosed. Yeah, maybe it's gonna be open later. Get a ride on it maybe and view of it off, because it's just a really nice carousel.
hear the sound of the bell. Thank you for riding the Grand Carousel. Enjoy the rest of your day. Come on, let's go.
Seen this yet? This is a new exhibit for me.
Wow.
Look at that. These are really cool animatronics. Can you imagine if they actually saw one of these in the woods? Such ominous. This is a such ominous. I mean, that's some good movement on that dinosaur right there. Oh, he's dead. Wow. Uh-oh, we found a nest. Wow, these are really awesome. Guys, they're so cute. Uh-oh, my gosh. Look at this. Uh-oh. Not bad. Not bad at all. Okay. So this used to be able to come down here to the Sciota and just, you know, look out at the Sciota River, which is very beautiful. But they've made it into a whole exhibit now with these dinosaurs, which is fantastic. Todd and I have been over there, and there is a dam right there. That is a dam. That is the O'Shaughnessy Dam. And let's go ahead and take a look at some footage that we shot a while back of the O'Shaughnessy Dam in that area over there. That video. We love flying our drones, and this really is a little Seymour aerial, but a business I'm trying to get going here, flying aerial shots and doing aerial shots is something I really want to get into. Really haven't quite broken through the ceiling yet on that one, but I'll continue to work on that. Love flying the drones, so Again, Scioto River. Just really beautiful. Oh, look at this. For you engineering geeks out there, they've actually got an animatronic here, Stegosaurus. And you can press the buttons to make it move. So let's press the first one here. Moves his tail back there. You can see the mechanism and engineering in behind that. There's the second button. That makes him rear up a little bit. Here's the third button. Turns his shoulders and his head. That's very cool. A lot of fun. Interactivity. Oh my gosh. Oh. Poor frog. That's horrible.
Enjoy the ride.
Alright. Oh, you can hear the O'Shaughnessy Dam from over here. Yeah. That's nice. A lot of water moving right now. I believe this is a hydroelectric dam. Well, alright, let's go on. Let's see if we can get some more dinosaurs.
These were the all instructions given to you by our ride operators. For rider safety, non-walking infants cannot ride. Lap sitting is not permitted.
Hold up, only two riders are permitted.
How are you? Not too many rides here, but I'm allowed to ride when I can. Ooh, we're floating. Hi. The bonobo up here. Brachiosaurus. There they are, up there. Oh, I think we got a spitter up here. Yeah, you said. It's a nice misty area here. It's gonna spit. It's gonna spit. Oh, I got wet. Oh. Oh, look what we have over here. Orangutans. That was a good area. I'm sorry we just missed, but I was trying to hide the camera from getting too wet. Looks like he's going for a climb. Lizards. AKA little dinosaurs. Oh my god, that's kind of freaking me out. Oh my god. Kind of jolting. Missing at me. Those are good. Where are the triggers? I want to know where the triggers are. That's fabulous. This is a really good ride. I'm really surprised. Oh, a little bit of carnage here. They got feathers, huh? Ooh, look at the mist. Look at the Milky. Oh, what's waiting for us in the mist? That's big. Yeah, this is a good ride. Very recommend. Gigantosaurus. Look at that thing. Looking right down at you. Uh-oh. T-Rex scene in the area. There it is. Wow. Tyrannosaurus. Fabulous. There it is. End of the ride. That was really, really good. I must say, that was beyond my expectations for that one. Really, really good animatronics. Fantastic surprises around the corners. And the mixture of the real wildlife that they've got here. Well, not real wildlife. Such as... Oh, this upset fella. That's not a bonobo. Who is that? Singing away. He's very upset. Stomping his foot and everything, you know? But this is a nice walkway. Just, you know, being a member, I think I'm going to come back here again and again just to get a walk in. Although, spending the $9.99 on the wristband to ride all the rides, it might get a little bit too much for me every time, but I wanted to do it this time. I'm wondering what's in here. Oh, Asian. Oh, the otters. Not sure they're here. I'm looking around for them. It looks like they're not out today. Oh, nope. There, I found them. There they are. Find something down there. What do they have? A large habitat. There you are. There's
some dogs and everything.
So good. Next time.
I need a nap too.
The 4D theater, I was thinking about doing that, but they said the Sharks one doesn't start until like 1 o'clock. So, and it's not even 11:30 yet. So, maybe let's go back to Africa and see if we can maybe do some things over there. Maybe even ride a camel? Should I ride a camel? Should I?
Are you?
We're ready. All right. Oh my gosh, it is bumpy. Wow!
Have you ever ridden one before?
No, it's first time for me. This is quite amazing. I mean, I've ridden a horse before.
A little bit different, not too much.
That loping.
But his name is Riddle.
Hey, Riddle.
About 9 years old. Uh-huh. He weighs right around 1,600 pounds.
Wow.
He stands about 7 foot tall.
Wow. It's kind of a satisfying lope, isn't it?
Yeah.
You okay there, Riddle?
Flies are biting.
Is that his tail?
Yeah.
This is cool.
Okay, now, you're right here.
Their humps are harder than I thought. Uh-huh.
So yeah, it's pretty hard, pretty sturdy.
Clean up at the station.
Don't go back in. Just watch your feet. Make sure they're nice and high above the platform.
Okay. How about that?
Come on. That's
pretty amazing. Thank you.
No problem.
See you, Riddle. They seem unimpressed.
Yeah, they're used to this, so they don't really get too much excitement out of it.
So as you can see, I just rode the camel. His name was Riddle. It was fun. It's amazing to be on a beast like that and to know that they are in complete control of where you're going and feel the power and the movement underneath you. So that was a lot of fun. Highly recommend it. Well, a slow day calls for a repeat ride. Again, for $9.99, I got this wristband and allowed me today to go on this riverboat ride, the camels, the carousel, the train, and to go and see, they're running three different 4D cinema movies today. I'm killing time going on this just one more time. Before that, I'm going to try to go see Storks, which I think is an animated feature thing. But then what I'm interested in is the shark one. So one more time on this, might as well take advantage of the free rides. Plus I get to sit down a little bit too. So here we go again. Hope my camera doesn't get wet. All right, my reactions to the 4D theater sharks. It was done by BBC, first of all, Earth. kind of old, dated, I would say, footage. The definition wasn't all that great as far as 3D, but, you know, it was 3D. I sat right smack dab in the middle in the second row, nobody in front of me. So, I don't know if you've ever done 4D before, but it's an experience where you have that three-dimensional because of the optics, but then also they have bubbles that go throughout the room in there, and then you get sprayed at certain times. Your seat rumbles. They said they were going to get poked in the back. I was waiting for the whole time for like a strike and something to poke me in the back, but it was just seat rumbles and that kind of thing. But it was good. I mean, with the wristband, $10 to do all of those. There's one that's not going on during the weekday right now, so it's $14.99 I think for that. I'm not sure what that is. Jack Hanna's thing or something. But it was a good day. And I've never done all the rides and that kind of thing here, so they were pretty interesting. All right, we're gonna head on back to the exit here. I may look through the gift shop and see if there's anything. Members get gift. So it's gotten dark. Oh my gosh. We'll see you at the exit. So Jungle Jack's Landing is the thing that, the other thing you could do with the wristband, I guess only on weekends. But again, that's Zumbezi Bay over there. A lot of log plume. There's a log plume right there. There's pirate rides, slides, that kind of thing. I can't really see what's going on over here. This is the new construction that they'll have open next year. So looking forward to that. All right, what a good day at the zoo. I did some things I've never done before. The rides, because you usually have to pay extra, and I thought, what the heck? I didn't have to pay my gate entry because of membership. But I went ahead and bought the wristband, rode all the rides I could today on a weekday, and had a really good time. I especially liked the boat ride. Did that twice. And the camel ride was a hoot. And 4D theater, whatever. I've seen those kind of things before, but it was interesting. Merry-go-round's classic. It's really pretty. And a good day at the Columbus Zoo. If you've never been here, you've got to come here when you come to Columbus. Rated one of the best zoos in the country, if not the world. And we were number one at one time. We always kept going back and forth with the San Diego Zoo and the Columbus Zoo. But not sure where we're at right now. I'll do some research and figure it out when I get home. All right, thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.